I cannot enter.
See them fancy clothes? This one's a top!
It's locked. Good evening, Jonathan. How are you?
I'm still investigating from inside the Ascalon Club. Can we talk?
Of course, my dear.
How is your investigation going?
I have decided to explore...
What do you mean?
You may...
When will you return?
As soon as possible.
Who are you going to...
No.
I have investigated new sources of infection, and I may have found a new type of skull. One suffering from heavy mutations that is extremely contagious.
Skulls come in various forms, you know. They are simply degenerate versions of their makers.
I believe these families are different, and I'm currently pursuing a lead. I know I can find the true source of contagion by finding who created these creatures.
That would be great news. Be very careful, my dear, when dealing with such creatures.
There are many paintings adorning the walls here.
Yes.
Did you paint them?
No, my dear. But some of them. I have had a long time to learn from the best. I'm currently working on what could be my greatest masterpiece.
Have you met any famous painters?
Are you trying to divine my age by cross-checking historical dates, my dear? That's a devious parlor trick.
Well, Elizabeth, I tried my best. Don't I deserve some reward, at least?
Well, if you must know, I even posed for the greats. Now that you know it, you may recognize me when visiting museums.
What is this?
Your portrait, my dear John.
Goodbye, my...
Goodbye.
It's locked. It's locked, all right.
Thank you.
There's an open window on the second floor. I should be able to get in through that.
It's locked, all right.
In front of you stands the tall queen.
Can that be Doris Fletcher's voice? Where does it come from?
I can't believe I'm doing this.
Who are you? You who dared enter my realm. Are you here to worship or mock me?
I'm here to put an end to the vampire epidemic, Miss Fletcher.
Ah. But Doris Fletcher is no more. She was consumed by this putrid flesh that now enshrouds her.
You feel anger for what happened to you. But I can help you. I'm a doctor, Miss Fletcher.
Doris Fletcher is no more. All that remains are the dreams of the queen she was and the queen she'll be. Until then, all shall die, for that was her final wish. Your blood, I summon thee, my children of the night. Slayer, the disgrace of she once renowned. Will she be the queen again once they all share her fate? You killed my father. Touché, sir. Your blood will be mine! Touché! Will she be the queen again? Dispel your fear. Come to me, my servants. Avenge me! Wait. I beg you, wait.
What?
I don't want to die.
And I did not come to kill you, Miss Fletcher.
Will you spare me then? Save this cadaverous carcass of mine. Does your heart beat a little faster now? You fancy me then, Doctor?
No, Miss Fletcher. My dead heart will beat for only one.
Ah! Is she pretty? Is she sweet and tender?
To me, yes.
Ah! I hate her already.
I know. And this is partly why you must be destroyed.
But you just said...
that I did not come here to kill you, yes. But I realize now, the threat you embody must be stopped.
Will I be remembered? Will you?
You were Doris Fletcher, the greatest actress of her generation. No one can take that from you.
Thank you. And farewell.
Farewell, Doris.
Bravo! So dramatic. I love it.
McCullum.
How strange I seem to find you whenever I'm inquiring about that skull infestation.
I mean you no harm.
I'm not here for you. But once I put all the pieces of the puzzle together, I'm sure we'll have a little chat, you and me.
Stay away from me, McCullum. You and all your war dogs.
That I can't guarantee, Dr. Reed. But I'll let you go. For now.
I should probably leave the theater right now.